Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Hashtag Newlywed Goals. Be sure to check out my latest blog post called Embrace the Differences at turnupgirlreverse.wordpress.com. Let's jump into it because that's what we're talking about today. We're talking about embracing those differences in a marriage and what that looks like. I touched on it previously in one of my earlier videos. I talked about those differences, but I think it's so funny because every time I think about embracing the differences, I always think about what people always ask me the most, and that is, what have I learned the most out of being married? And I always say the same thing: love the differences as much as you love the similarities. I find it so funny that we love those differences. We love those quirky traits that our spouses have prior to us getting married. Like, we love everything about them. We think it's adorable. However, once we jump into marriage, that quirkiness and those differences will sometimes become our biggest frustrations. And I think it's kind of funny how that flip-flops. But I'm here to tell you guys that our differences, of course, is what make us unique. That's what make us special. I always joke with Tyler because sometimes I always kind of want him to be like a mini Clark. Clark is actually my maiden name. And I have certain Clark traits that distinguish myself just like my brothers and my mom and my dad. So I kind of always joke with Tyler about, you should be like a mini Clark, and try, you know, jokingly say that. But we have to be careful when we try to compare our spouses to our families and just everything, you know, that make us unique and special. That kind of can hurt your spouse a little bit. So be careful when you're trying to do that, because comparison is a tough thing. So just be careful when you do that. I know I always say that I joke with it, but I also have to make sure that I don't joke that much about it or try to hurt his feelings or think that I'm trying to compare him and want him to be like a mini Clark, so to speak. So just be careful when you do that. I always tell people, like, you can learn so much from your spouse just by their differences. Their differences can make you into a better person. For instance, my husband loves people. Like, there is not a stranger that he doesn't meet. Like, he genuinely loves and cares for people. I, on the other hand, prior to him, I really didn't care to really talk to a lot of people or open up to a lot of people. Like, that really wasn't me. I really just stuck in my own bubble. But because of him, now I love people. I love caring about people. I love talking to people. And it's all because of how he was made. And that's what I want you guys to get out of your spouse, is whatever makes them different, whatever makes them unique, can change your character. Just like my husband helped me with my character and how to be kind and patient and loving to people, that's the same thing that your spouse can do for you and whatever their differences may be. So don't think of their differences as something bad. Think of it as something that can help and benefit your marriage, and vice versa. The same thing applies to you. Whatever you have that is different applies to your spouse. That can help them as well. So just to sum everything all up, embrace the differences. Love those differences just as much as you love the similarities. It is what makes us all unique and different, and it makes things interesting. If we all were alike, it would be so boring. So be careful when you compare your spouse. Be careful when you are getting irritated about something that you may not like, whatever that character trait may be. Be careful with that, and know that that is what makes them unique. That is what sets them apart, and that is what makes them different. Okay, guys, it's been fun. Thank you guys for tuning in, as always. Be sure to subscribe, and also be sure to follow all of my social media on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. What else?